Hey guys, welcome to YouTube channel where we talk all about the GATE exam and we are into the quick revision videos of operating system. So unit 1 I summarized in the last video. Now I am solving some question from the multi-programming concept, the category of multi-programming operating system. So let's follow the question. The very first question I have taken is from the GATE 2002. The question is like here. And this question is very likely to become a multiple selection question, which is included in this year exam format. That means multiple options can be correct. So you need to have a good practice in order to analyze the statements, because multiple statements could be given and not only one is true or false, multiple could be true and multiple could be false, which you need to identify properly. So the question says, which combination of the following features will suffice to characterize an operating system as a multi-programmed operating system? That means the given statements, which of them supports, which of them is there to define that if it is present in a system, that is a multi-programmed operating system. Okay, so let's understand the statement number one. Statement number one is, more than one program may be loaded into main memory at the same time for execution. In the revision, I told you that multi-programmed operating system, in the main memory, we can put multiple processes. Okay, and it is the stored program concept from the von Neumann architecture. So whatever number of processes are present in the main memory, we can allow any one of them to get executed on the CPU at any moment of time. So that's really makes up the sense that more than one program may be loaded into the main memory. Only if it is present into the main memory, then only it can be executed. And if it is multiple process present into the main memory, that only makes up the multi-programming operating system. I mean, that is essential to be a multi-programming operating system. So yes, this statement is correct. Okay, second, if a program waits for certain events such as input output, that means from CPU a process is moving to the input output, another program is immediately scheduled for execution. What is it? Again, the efficient utilization of CPU, which is possible only when we have the multi-program operating system, right? Which was not possible in the uniprogram, because even if P1 is going for the input output, the CPU is idle because we have no process in the main memory to schedule back to the CPU. Okay, so that was the problem in the uniprogram, which is not the problem in multiprogram. If this situation is possible, that means it suffices that this operating system is a multiprogram operating system. So yes, this statement is also true. So you can consider this as a practice for MSQ. The third statement is, if the execution of a program terminates, another program is immediately scheduled for execution. If a program execution just terminates, then even in the uniprogram operating system, we will take a new process and we will put it into the main memory and it will be given to the CPU. Okay, correct? Because the memory space which the previous program was consuming in the main memory is empty now, because that program or this process has been terminated. Correct? So this thing does not essentially say that it is the multi-programmed OS. This statement also applies to the uniprogrammed OS, right? This one is not essential, essentially sufficing the condition to be a multi-program operating system or characteristic to be a multi-program operating system. This characteristic is available in uniprogrammed also. Right? So then out of the three, this is true, and this one is not A and B. Exactly, A and B. We don't need the C, we just need A and B for the characteristic of an operating system to be a multi-programmed operating system. Alright, so the next question is from the GATE 2015, from the set 3. Very simple, very easy question. Yet understanding, it's going to make you understand the number of processes possible in the multiprocessor system, in the multiprogram system. So here the question is, the maximum number of processes that can be in ready state. So important to understand is, it is talking about the ready state. Okay, this is very important to understand. For a computer system with n CPU, Okay, so this is a computer system which has multiple CPUs. So this is of the type multiprocessor operating system. You will have multiple processors, multiple CPUs. And how many such are there? Like CPU 1, okay, CPU 2. Likewise, how many CPUs are there? Number n. We have such n CPUs. So the maximum number of process that can be present in the ready state. Ready state is the state when the process is ready to be executed, but it is not executing. Ready state means the number of process possible in the main memory. It is not talking about the number of process on the CPU. It is talking about in the main memory. Before answering how many are possible in the ready queue, I would answer how many are possible in running state. Because I have n CPUs, so I can assign one process here. I can assign one process here and I can assign one process here. Likewise, in between, I can assign the processes n minus 1. So I can have from 1 to n processes which can be running on different CPUs. So if the question asks how many processes are possible in the running state, then I would say option A is the right answer. But the question is asking that how many are possible in your main memory, then I would say there is no limit for it. You can make room for any number of processes. Or you can say there is no relation with the number n. Okay, it is totally independent of n. Answer is option D, independent of n. Why? Because there is no limitation. I mean, I can have some two process, I can have n minus one process, I can have n plus one process. That's dependent on how many are getting created, what is the number of rooms available here, how they are getting terminated. It is dependent on all that, but definitely not on dependent on the number of CPUs present. So even though it is a multiprocessor system where we have n CPU, the number of process present in the ready state is totally independent of the value n. Alright, so this was the question asked in the GATE 2015. And here I think the questions which were important to understand: multiprogramming, uniprogramming, preemptive, non-preemptive, multiprocessing, multi-user operating system are done. In the next video, I'm going to come up with the state transition diagrams, its quick revision, and the respective questions. Keep following. See you then.